The next topic is going to be friend functions. What is friend? What is a friend function? How is it useful? This is a very important point of discussion when somebody learns C++. This needs some code for its explanation. Let me come to the code part. What is a friend function? A friend function is a very important added advantage or an innovation that has happened in C++. This facility is not available in C. Since the access specifier is not supported in C, it is quite obvious that no other related innovations in programming can come into C programming. So it is very obvious there. So what is a friend function? It is simple. I'll tell you a relevant practical example. Assuming that I have a very close friend of mine, I will permit him to come to my house. He can access my almari. He can access my almira or my rack. He can take my wallet if at all he wants, and he can check for any requirement of money. So he is my close friend. That's what I mean to say here. I give him access to touch my materials that I have in my rack. My components of the class are permitted to be touched by my friend. Though private, when I give access, it can be made accessible for my friend. So how about making a function friend for particular? How about making a function a very close friend in such a way that the private members can be accessed? This is exactly the friend function. Declaring a function as private and defining it properly. Declaring a function as a friend and defining it properly will permit you to access the private contents of a class, which means that a friend can go ahead and access the private data members of a particular class also, if at all they are friends. So the friendship is respected here. A keyword by name friend is required for the declaration of the function. Once you declare it as friend, the function will have all authority to go ahead and have access to the data members of private access specifiers that you have already discussed. Okay. It is pretty simple here. So please listen to the code carefully. And I have written a very small code. We need an object. The private data members are all accessible by the friend function, and it can be done through the object. So an object of the class must be passed as an argument to the function which wishes to access the private data members. I repeat, an object of the class has to be passed as an argument to the function. An object of the class, which means you need to create an object that has to be passed as an argument which wishes to access the private members. So it is simple here. See the code. I have got a private A and B, private data members here. They are private now. Now I have got something in public. Test. It's a simple function where I initialize A with 10 and B with 20. Now what I am trying to do is, I am trying to access this A and B. I am going to try to access this A and B, which are private data members, through the function that I am going to use in public now. Friend int calculate base class even. I have already told you that an object of the class has to be passed as an argument to the function. This is what I told you some time back. So this is the function, this is the friend function, where I am passing the object as argument. Now I have declared the function very clearly. Now the definition of the function comes. I accept the copy of the content into X, base class X. I accept the object here. Now inside that I do some calculation. Let's not worry about what is it. It's a simple thing. Now I have got a private body, I have got a public body, I have got the function declaration and function definition. The function declaration has conveyed that it is a friend function, and an object of a class has been passed as an argument to the function calculate. And through this object, it will be easier for anybody to access the private data members. My intention is to access the private data members through the object that I am passing to the function which I have referred as friend. I made it very, very clear. So it's very easy now. Now come to the main part. Base class E. So which means that I have created an object. This has been now passed here. So E dot, let's hold on for a minute. This has not been passed. Let's forget all those stories. I have created an object. Now the next step is E dot test. What do you mean by this test? Test is a function that is available here. So when I call the function test through the object, it will obviously come here, and A will be allocated with 10 and B will be allocated with 20. And now calculate of E. So now the friend function now is used here. I have already made it a friend, so I am calling that function calculate, so it will come here and the calculation will happen this way. X dot A, X dot B, X dot A into X dot B plus 10 minus 6. So how did this A and B get accessible here? It is simple. I passed it here, calculate of E, which means that I have already conveyed this is a friend. So this function has got all the eligibility to access the data members which are private. So I have got it now. Hence the result will come as 204. It is again simple. What I am telling you is we need an object for accessing. We need an object from the class which has to be passed as an argument to the function. So what did we do here? We passed an object. This is nothing but an object. I am passing the object. The object has been already in relationship with the function, and that is a friend function. And that friend function will let you access the private data members. That's what I have done here. It's very clear, and we got some output. So if at all you want to access the private data members, you make an object, you make the function friend, you pass the object as an argument to the friend function. That's it. Now here, this is an object that I have passed, and now it enables me to go ahead further. This is the simplest of all things, and this is the best example that we can give for friend function. So this has to be practiced to get more familiarity with it. So I would request you to try it once with more examples.